गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। सो वी आर डूइंग प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन इनकम फ्रॉम सैलरीज चैप्टर एंड वी हैव अ पिक्ड हेड हाउस रेंट अलाउंस। वी हैव डन सम प्रॉब्लम्स एंड विल डू टू और थ्री प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन दिस। ओके, दिस कुड बी आस्क्ड फॉर 5 मार्क्स। सो वॉट इज सेइंग, मिस्टर मिश्रा इज एन एम्प्लॉई ऑफ एपी स्टेट गवर्नमेंट। सो मिश्रा इज वर्किंग इन एपी स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, आंध्र प्रदेश इज वर्किंग। हिज सैलरी पर्टिकुलर्स आर एज फॉलोज। बेसिक पे 18,000 पर मंथ। This is per month, we have to convert into per annum. Dearness allowance is given 7,500 per month. City compensatory allowance is given 1,800 per month. House rent allowance is given 6,000 per month. And rent paid by him is 7,500 per month. Okay. So what he is saying, compute exempted house rent allowance and taxable HRA. Both things he is asking you to find out. First, find out how much is exempt, then how much is taxable. So the page number is 146. Okay, the 13th problem we are doing. So it's very easy. He has given all the information is per month. We have to convert into per annum. Now here DA, EDA is saying only DA, DNS allowance. He should say in bracket part of salary or enters into service benefits. So he is not saying anything. So we have to take only basic pay. So we will write heading as, so we'll solve, start solving. So our problem is 13th problem. So he, where is working? He is working in Andhra Pradesh. Mr. Mishra is working in Andhra Pradesh. Okay. For house rental allowance, we should not see government employee or private employee. Just we have to see where he is working. Okay. So, what we have to do? HRA. Exempt HRA is least of the following. List of the following we have to take. First, we have to take 40% of salary. Why we are taking 40% of salary? Because he is staying in Andhra Pradesh. Okay. So here we are having only 18,000 per month. We don't include because in bracket he is not saying. In brackets you have to say part of salary or enters into service benefits. He is not saying we will not take DNS allowance. Okay. So I am writing here 18,000 into 12 months. 18,000 this is per month. You have to convert into per annum. Okay, so 18,000 into 12, if we do, we get 2,16,000 as salary of per annum. Of this we have to take 40%. Okay, into 40%, we're getting 86,400. Number two, actual HRA received. Actual HRA, how much he is saying actual HRA? 6,000 per month, house rent allowance. So 6,000 into 12, if we do, we'll get 72,000. Okay, so we are getting actual HRA 72,000. Next, Roman number 3, rent paid minus 10% of salary. How much he's paying rent? He's paying rent 7,500 per month. So 7,500 into 12, we have to do. 7,500 into 12, if we do, we get 90,000 minus 10% of salary means 2,16,000 into 10%, we do, we'll get 21,600. Okay, so 2,16,000 into 10%, if we do, we get 21,600. 90,000 minus 21,600, we are getting 68,400. Okay, so least of the three is what? 68,400. So least of the three, 68,400. So this is exempted HRA. So we're getting exempted HRA as HRA 68,400. Okay, this is exempt. Now how much is taxable? We have to find out taxable HRA. Taxable HRA. Okay, so what to do? HRA received minus exempted HRA. We have to write exempted HRA. How much we have received HRA? That is 72,000. So 72,000 we have received HRA minus exempt is how much? 68,400, and we have to pay tax on 72,000 minus 68,400, 3,600 tax we have to pay on HRA. Okay, so it's very easy. What is given in the question? In the question he is saying Mr. Mishra is working in a state AP state government. So you do not see for house rental allowance, HRA, state government or private employee. Okay, so what we have to do? we have to do he's staying in Andhra Pradesh means 40% of salary. The least exempt HR is least of the following. So we have to do Roman number one, 40% of salary because he's staying in Andhra Pradesh. Actual HR is given in question. Rent paid is also given in question. 10% of salary we have to do. So 18,000 is saying basic pay. Okay, so 18,000 into 12 if we have done, so we are getting 2,16,000 into 40% we have to take because he is staying in Andhra Pradesh, non-metro. Actual HR received is 72,000. Rent paid is 7,500 into 12, we have got 90,000 minus 10% of salary, that is 10% of salary is 2,16,000, we are getting 21,600. So least of the three is 68,400. So exempted HR is 68,400. Okay, then taxable HRA we have to find out. How to find out taxable HRA minus exempted HRA? So HRA is how much is given in the question, 72,000. From that you deduct exempted 68,400. So we are getting 63,600 as taxable HRA. Okay, so like this we have to solve problems. It's very easy. Could be asked for 5 marks. Problem on the same page. Okay, so we are doing one more problem on the same page. Mr. Ram Lal working in Hyderabad and executive. His salary particulars are, so he is working in Hyderabad. And his information is given. Okay, so this we are having on the page number 147 continuation. So what he is saying, basic pay is given 1,80,000 per annum. The information is given in per annum. Per annum. Okay, next DNS bonus is 18,000, DNS allowance 18,000 per annum, part of salary. Part of salary means what? This we have to include. See, DNS bonus, salary definition for HR is what? Basic pay plus bonus, DNS allowance plus commission. Okay, so basic pay we are having here 18,000 per annum, DNS allowance 18,000 per 1,80,000 is, this is basic pay, and DNS allowance is 18,000 per annum, part of salary. Whenever part of salary is saying, you have to add in this basic pay. House rent allowance is 30,000, rent paid by him is 48,000 per annum. So all the information is given in per annum. So where he is staying, in Hyderabad. Hyderabad again is non-metro. Okay, so we'll solve this 14th problem. So where he is staying, in Hyderabad. Hyderabad is non-metro. Okay, again exempted HRA is this of the following. Exempted HRA. Is least of the following. Okay. Now first one we'll write 40% of salary. Why 40%? Because he's staying in non-metro. Okay. Salary means what we have to do? We have to take basic pay plus DA. Why DA? He is saying DA is a part of salary. Okay, so 1,80,000 plus 18,000. So we write 1,80,000 plus 18,000. So 1,80,000 plus 18,000, if we do, we get 1,98,000. Not 1,98,000, 196 we get. 1,80,000 plus 1,98,000 we are getting salary. 1,98,000 is per annum. For that we have to take 40%. We are taking 40% because he is staying in non-metro into 40%. 79,200. Okay, so 40% salary we are getting 14,200. Next, how much actual we are receiving? We are receiving HRA 30,000. So Roman number two, actual HRA received. How much we have received? 30,000. Okay, Roman number 3. What we have to do? Rent paid minus 10% of salary. So rent paid is there. How much is rent paid? See, 48,000 per annum. So we'll write 48,000 minus 10% of salary means 1,98,000 into 10%. Getting 19,800. Okay, from 48,000, if we deduct 19,800, you get 28,200. Okay, least of the three is what? 28,300. So exempted HRA is, exempted HRA is 28,200. Okay, so taxable we have to find out. Taxable HRA we have to find. It's very easy to find out taxable HRA. Taxable HRA, what to do? You have to write as एक्चुअल एच आर ए माइनस एग्जैम्प्ट एच आर ए एक्चुअली इज हाउ मच 30,000 माइनस एग्जैम्प्ट इज हाउ मच 28,200 द डिफरेंस ऑफ टू 1800 इज टैक्सेबल 1800 इज टैक्सेबल ईजी राइट यस नाउ नाउ सी दिस 15th वन ओके आई वॉन्ट यू टू सॉल्व दिस 15th वन श्रीमती शारदा इज अ लेक्चरर इन चेन्नई इज पर्टिकुलर्स हर पर्टिकुलर्स आर एज आर एज अंडर सो शी इज वर्किंग इन चेन्नई चेन्नई मीन्स वॉट मेट्रो सिटी ओके सो बेसिक पे इज 7,000 पर मंथ डी एन एस अलेवेंस 4,000 पर मंथ डी एन एस इज नॉट सेइंग इन ब्रैकेट सो डू नॉट टेक डी एन एस अलेवेंस सी सी ए इज सिटी कंपनसिटी अलेवेंस इज 1,000 हाउस रेंट अलेवेंस इज 1,000 पर मंथ एंड रेंट पेड बाय हर इज 1,800 पर मंथ सो यू हैव टू बी केयरफुल हियर एवरीथिंग इज गिवन पर मंथ सो यू हैव टू कन्वर्ट इन टू पर एनम वेर शी इज स्टेइंग इन चेन्नई सो यू हैव टू टेक 50% ऑफ सैलरी फॉर सैलरी यू हैव टू टेक ओनली बेसिक पे 7,000 इंटू 12 यू हैव टू टेक ओके And she's staying in Chennai, so 50% of salary you have to take. And rest you know. So I want you to solve this problem. It's very easy to solve.